Hello everyone. In previous topic, we have studied what is software testing and the various events happened due to the failure of softwares. In today's class, we'll see what actually the defects are, why software testing is necessary, and what are the reasons which causes the software failure. So let us understand what is a defect or bug in a software. A defect is an error in coding or logic that causes a program to produce incorrect or unexpected results. A person makes an error, because of that it creates a fault in software and that can cause a failure in operation. As you know that software is a collection of programs. A software works well only when you execute those programs and remove the errors. A program must be without errors. Then only the software works properly and you get the results as you expected. So removing the defects from the software is necessary. Now let us understand why software testing is necessary. The testing is important as it discovers defects or bugs before the delivery of the software to the clients or users, and also to ensure that product works as user requirements, needs and expectations, which guarantees the quality of the software. Suppose a client wants a particular software and a client wants that software for his shop. So he is going to tell the software developer or the tester what kind of software he wants, what are his requirements, and when he wants the software to be delivered. So the person who is developing the software is his responsibility to gather proper requirements from the customers. Sometimes even the customers may not able to tell the exact requirements. So as a developer or the tester, you are going to use various techniques and methods to find out exact and all requirements. And also the tester's job is to test those gathered requirements, whether those gathered requirements are meeting the software objectives or no. You can also see in the organization, there are different teams for requirements gathering, developing and testing. So if you meet user requirements, needs and expectations, it also guarantees the software quality. Next we'll see to detect defects early, which helps in reducing the cost of defect fixing and also to avoid extra costs. Yes, it is always good that to find out the defects as early as possible so that it can also reduce the cost of defect fixing. Okay, once you deliver the system to the clients and if the clients detect the defects, then there are the chances of increasing the cost. Next, to avoid user detecting problems. Yes, as a software developer or as a software tester, your job is to find the defects before the customers find them. The customer should not call you or tell you that there are the defects or the problems in the software or the software is not working. Okay, so you should avoid that. That's why you need to test the software. Next, to prove that the software has no faults, it is needed for correctly understanding the faults. Yes, once you detect the faults in the software, analyze those faults properly and what is the reason of occurring it and how well you can fix it. You need to analyze this. You need to understand it. Thoroughly tested software ensures reliable and high performance software operation. If your software is tested properly, it is going to be reliable and keeps on operating for long hours without any failures. So it gives high performance software. Next, make software safe and user friendly. Yes, testing is necessary to keep your software safe. And user friendly means how well your the user can use the software. The software must be easy to understand for the user. It must be not very complicated, and that is user friendly. To avoid being sued by customers. Yes, the customers will be investing in the software, so they want error-free softwares. If there are defects in the software or if the software is violating some rules and regulations, there are the chances that customers may charge you all. Next, to stay in business. Softwares are used in every business and it is used in very important places. So thorough testing is needed to stay in business. Next, we'll see reasons of software failures. Okay, first reason is unrealistic or unarticulated project goals. See, before beginning any software, it is very necessary to understand what are the project goals, what are the software objective, what is the purpose of yours developing the software. So if you don't analyze it and if you don't mention it properly, so project goal or objective is the main intention to develop the software. So it is very necessary to analyze it properly, otherwise there are the chances of software failure. Next, incomplete requirements and changing requirements. Yes, this is also one big reason for the software failure. This is because some of the requirements you miss out to developing software and which may further create the problems in software. When that real situation arises and if the software is not able to handle that situation, then the software fails. We already seen some of the incidents like flight control system and missile defense system which failed due to the errors in the software. In the flight control system, we have seen that it was unable to communicate with the control office due to the software error, because this happened because of not properly recognizing the requirements. So when that situation arise on that spot, it failed to communicate with the control office. Similarly, missile defense system, it also failed to detect the exact position of the enemies due to which the many soldiers were killed. So these are the effects if you miss out some requirements because the softwares are used in very important places. Next, a lack of logic. See, logic is very important when you are developing the software as well as when you are testing it. See, most often software engineers, software testers or the developers do not have a good design or logic before coding or writing programs. So this is the major cause of software failure today. Some of the software developers or the testers, software engineers start coding without having a good design. Such software is going to fail. It is like an architect that is building a house without plan. Building a house this way will waste time and cost more. Yet the house architect may never correct all the errors in the house. The same is with the software. Once software does not have a very good design and logic, the software is bound to be failed when you put it into use. Next, we'll see inadequate software testing. See, once you start developing the software, you also start testing it. Software engineers or the testers do not adequately test their code before releasing them to customers. For software to be reliable and free of defects, the software must be properly debugged. Testing must be repeated several times. It is not that testing has to be done once. To find out the hidden defects, you need to test it repeatedly. The software tester should test the software with all available data, with both imaginary and real data, to ensure that the system is able to handle them without crashing. Both imaginary and real data, Assuming these all things, the software has to be tested. Then only it is going to avoid the software failure. Next we'll see poor communication among customers, developers and users. To find out the requirements, there must be the proper communication between the customer, developers and users. Unless they communicate well, so there are some of the hidden requirements or some requirements will be missed out if they don't communicate properly. So unless they communicate, the requirements won't come out. So poor communication or miscommunication among the customer, developers and users can also cause the software failure. Next, failures may also be caused by someone deliberately trying to cause a failure in the system. See, there are some people who are deliberately trying to break the system. Means they are going to change something in the software or hack it or change the code so that the software does not function properly and the software fails. So this is also a reason which causes the software to be failed. Next, poor reporting of the project status. See, reporting is also very important here. See, whatever you develop, keep proof of that. Report is one proof how you have developed the software, what you have done for testing and maintenance. So these all reports you are going to maintain. See, if you get some error and you fix it, even that reporting you should do. So that in future, if you get any errors, how you handle that error, you come to know from the reporting. So reporting must be also proper for the software. Next is use of immature technology. See, whatever the technology you are using for developing the software, which you have not understood properly, then again it is going to lead a software failure. So the technology which you are thorough in that, so it's better to use that technology to develop the software. Or if you don't know that technology, you learn it, you understand it, and then make use of that. Next, poor maintenance of software. Yes, after developing the software or after testing the software, your work is not finished. Still, you need to maintain it. See, like when you purchase any product from the market, and if you don't maintain it properly, it is not going to exist for a longer period of time. Same way is with software. You need to maintain it regularly to keep it secured and safe. Now, let us understand who should test. As we have seen that there is a team of developer and there is a team of software tester. So the work of developer is to understand the system, to program it, write the coding for that within the deadlines. So the more focus will be not on the testing. They are trying to complete the coding within the deadlines. Whereas software tester must also learn the system. They will try to break the system. Break the system means they are trying to find out the faults in the system so that there must be no any defects in the system. And it also improves the quality of the software. So here, both developer and testers are important in order to deliver the product with all requirements and error-free. A developer must be good in programming and writing codes, whereas the tester must be good in finding the defects from various applications, and the tester report those defects back to the developers so that the developers can fix those and solve those and remove those errors from the software. Let us understand how was the trend in earlier days between the tester and the developer. So let us see the trend in the 1960s earlier days. So this is a tester, software tester, and this is a software developer. So the software tester situation was like, why does not he understands the importance of testing? And the situation of software developers were like, why want to test it? I have done the coding and have implemented all the features, and moreover, I don't have time to do the so-called testing. So this was happening because in earlier days, the softwares were used in very less important places. There was very less focus on testing. Next, how the generation has moved forward, the importance of testing and the awareness of testing was increased. See, what was the situation in 1990s? The software would say, see, I told you before. And what the software developer would say? Okay, maybe you were right. I should have done some testing. Customers are complaining that there are many bugs in production. So as the generation has moved forward, they understood the importance of testing and they should focus on testing. In today's trend, see what the tester says. It's all testers' responsibility. Testers need to learn and work harder and deliver fast. So, this is the situation nowadays because the softwares are used in very important places where a single bug or the defect is not acceptable. And it may lead to the disastrous events, and it may cause the financial loss as well as human loss. So, I hope you all understood the topic. Thank you.